I have decided to, it's kind of icy here, to work on my black and white photography. I realized what I know about black and white photography is zero, and I've been just kind of doing it wrong all this time. So I've been studying up on that. I found some tutorials. I've been watching those. So I'm working on that. I drove down to Tacoma today. So I was, when we were coming back from the Oregon coast, I came across this cool bridge. And I wanted to shoot that. And then I'll convert it to black and white. So I'm going to try and find a good spot to get set up. The sun rises pretty soon. And hopefully, maybe get some color in the clouds, maybe not. If I do, I won't convert them all to black and white because I really like the color. But I'm going to work on that for now. Try and get a composition set up. There is a spot kind of over there where those cars are, where the trail loops around and comes back up. So I'll go over there as well. See what I can do over there. There's also another round, cool kind of building over here. It's like the Chihuly Museum or something like that. So I'm going to scope that out. Hopefully come up with something good, and it's kind of round too, so I can make a really good black and white effect on that. So I'm gonna get all set up and I'll let you know what I come up with. I came down to shoot the bridge, but I found this cool building right here with the stairs going up and the little lights on. So I'm shooting that right now. I've got my 100-400 lens on f11. I'm bracketing my exposures. There are the lights on. As you can see, what I've shot so far, you can see you got the stairs, got the little triangles, and as I, you know, there's my dark image, middle image, and then one I shot just a few minutes ago, same thing bracketed. So I really like the look of that. I'm gonna sit here and shoot that a little bit longer and then keep wandering that way. So you can see that, there's that round building I was talking about, whatever it is, I have no idea. But I'm gonna work on that one as well with the architectural photography, then convert it to black and white. So for now, I'm gonna keep working this little scene here. So I'm at the round building here. Let's see, that one there. I've currently got a 4-minute exposure going. Hopefully that'll streak the clouds really well. Got my lead 10 stopper on. It's pretty cool because you have the stairs that kind of lead up and the whole thing's kind of round, heads up that direction. Right now I've got like the white hailish snow kind of in the foreground here and the building in the background. I've cut off all of the city and everything, so that should be good. Otherwise, see some color up there, but it's just totally in the wrong direction. So, I don't know about the bridge. There's gray clouds right behind it, kind of blend with it. But we'll see. I'll walk around it and see what else I can find over there. But for now, I'm just going to let this finish up. And hopefully it'll turn out pretty well. If not, I'll redo it. So I just broke out the Lee 15 stopper. It gives me a shutter speed of 6 minutes and 40 seconds. So I came over to the other side. I'm not sure if I like the composition. So I have the bricks here in the foreground. I kind of zigzagged. I've got that in the background, focusing on the building itself and not the bricks. So we'll see how it turns out. Like I said, I'm not sure if I'm happy with the composition. So I may just throw this photo away. But you never know. So you look at them on the computer and you're like, hey, that's actually a good photo. So I'm just going to finish up this shot. I'm going to wander probably a little farther north. I'm still trying to figure out if I can shoot the bridge, or I may go back to the other side of the bridge and then shoot north and see if there's anything that way. So we'll see what happens when I get over there. So I'm leaving Tacoma now. I'm going to head home, get my photos up on the computer. And then once I do that, I'll go through and edit and show you guys what I found and how I'm editing my photos. I don't know if I'll go through black and white because that can be a long process. So I'll show you what I've got going. Okay, so here is the Chihuly Museum. Yeah. So I got the photos up in the Photoshop, and this is the Chihuly Glass Museum down in Tacoma, the one I shot this morning. You can see his long exposure. See the nice streaking clouds. See a spot of something up there I'll have to fix. So the first thing I did was I made a copy of the bottom of the main photo. That way I never touched the original photo. And from there, I did a black and white adjustment layer. So you can see, just converted to black and white. And when you use just the black and white converter, it just kind of makes everything a gray tone. Yeah, and then you have to adjust everything, but it just doesn't work as well as the black and white gradient map. You can see just the difference in them. Basically what it does is the gradient map looks at your darker colors and your lighter colors and makes like your blues, because they're darker than your yellows, darker tone in your photo. So just adjust it better from the start. And then I did a curves adjustment. I'm not quite sure what that one did. Let's see. So come up here, see what it did. Oh, so that was just something from a previous adjustment. And then, so you can see I made this other layer. Basically what I did is I took the selection I made of this rail here, and I basically made it brighter up top, darker in the bottom, to kind of give it some depth. And you can see I also brightened the sky a little bit with that. And the way I did this rail over here is I made all these selections first off. Here's that little sidewall. Here's a museum. And this one took a long time, because you can see inside all these railings that I had to adjust or make a selection of. Every little bit and piece in there. So that one took a long time. But that's the trick to making good black and whites, is you spend the time to make your selections. And I made one of the sky as well. And this, the same thing, it took a long time, because you have all these railings here I had to get on the inside of. But I just used the pen tool, and the pen tool actually works pretty slick. So it made it a lot easier. So let's go back. And I'm not showing you how, all the edits I did. I'm just showing you the steps that I took. And then here's another layer here. You can see I just brightened it up a little bit. And then I did a selection of the sky and just did an exposure selection. See, it really brought down the sky. That way it'll really separate out the museum here. And then I did a curves adjustment. So on this curves adjustment, what I did is, you can see, here's the mask. I just used a lasso tool and just did a freehand sketch, and then just hit the curves adjustment layer, and it brought up the selection. Of course, when you do that, it's, at least on my settings, it's backwards. Basically everything on the inside of the selection is going to be adjusted, everything on the outside won't be. So I just hit Command I on my Mac, or Control I think on a PC. I don't know, I just use a Mac. And then I did a Gaussian blur of like 500. So what that does is, because with your lasso tool, it just makes a hard edge. And with the Gaussian blur, it blurs that edge. So I just use 500, that's 500 pixels basically. And then it gives me this nice soft edge. And then from there, all I did was, I just brought down the curves adjustment a little bit. Just to realize, so you can kind of see the adjustment. You can see it's kind of does something like this. As I turn that on and off, and see. And then from there, I did a slight adjustment on the railings. This was just a freehand. All I did here was, you can see, I just brought the curve way up, used the brush tool at like 20% opacity, and then just freehand brushed everything in. I wasn't going to take the time to, do these railings perfectly, because you really don't need to. If you zoom in here, you can see that they are pretty big and pretty easy to follow. If you just zoom in, you can just freehand that anyways. But you can see it does make a difference. If I turn that on and off, it really brings them out, kind of gives more leading lines into the photo. And then from there, I actually just copied that layer. Now we just made them a little bit more bright, you can see. And then this one's very subtle. You can see on the stairs, the sky, where the clouds were a little bit, and I streaked those Just a little bit, not too much though. And then, so the curves, I did a little bit more on the stairs. And then I use a black and white program. It's a plugin for Photoshop, Black and White Artisan Pro. And I did the dramatic black and white adjustment, and it really brought out the sky. So from there, I just added the sky selection that I made earlier. You can see that. Because if you turn that off, so I turn the selection off, you can see it darkens everything. But I just wanted the sky. And so I just added the sky selection, so only the white is selected. And then that's what that one does. Really brought out the whites around the glass museum. And from there, made another adjustment layer. You can see how I darken the backside of the museum. Kind of gives it more depth, kind of gives it more round look to it. And then kind of the same thing, I made the right side of it darker, the center brighter on this one. And this is all something I do with that Artisan Pro. It makes it really simple. You can just kind of circle things and make zone selections, and it works out pretty well. And then this curves adjustment layer, you can see I brought it down, and what happened was, as I was making all my adjustments, you can see the edge of the museum here just wasn't getting selected. So I made a curves adjustment and then just brushed all this in. You can see it's not perfect by any means, but it's definitely better. It doesn't stand out as much as it did before. So I go back out, you can see how it's bright there, and then it darkens back up. And then this is the one I made the luminosity mask of. You can see the buildings in the background. I'll zoom into those real quick. You can see as I turn that on and off. Just really emphasize those. I really like that look. I'll zoom back out. And then this layer, this is the one where I just went through and cleaned up all the little spots. You can see that spot up there is gone. There are a couple other little spots around there. So that's all that layer did. And then another curves adjustment. I wanted to brighten this one up. As you can see here, because the reason I did that is I made another layer, and I made this a multiply layer. So if you go up to your, where it says normal, your blend mode, and I went down to multiply, and it just really darkened it. And so by doing that, I wanted to brighten it up first, and then I just drug my opacity down. So I click on that, you can see multiply. So if I go up to 100%, you can see how much. But if I didn't do that, see, it went really dark. So that's why I left it pretty bright. So let's drag that back down to 58%. So the last thing I like to do on my black and whites is use a lookup table. You can see this lookup one. And as you can see how it's kind of a bit of a yellowish tint. And so all I do is just add a slight blue. You can see up here there's a blue tone. There's tons of different options here, as you can see. So I just always like the blue tone. You can see when you first do it, it starts out like that, so it's really blue. But I just drag the opacity down to like anywhere from 6 to 10%, depending on the photo. It just adds a little bit of a coolness to it. I just really like the look of slightly blue black and whites instead of the yellowish greenish tint. And then that's about it. And unfortunately, this file is so big. You can see 2.26 gigs, so that's larger than you can save as a TIFF. So I just had to save it as a .psb file, which is a large document file. And then from there, in the Raya Pro, it has this RP actions and filters. So this way I can sharpen it for the web. I won't actually go through the process, but it's time to load. So you can see here, sharpen and resize for the web. So I just, because it's a landscape orientation, I just hit the by width. Go 2500, because that's the pixels that I want. and then it just saves a copy of it, sharpens it. It actually sharpens it three times, but I don't like the third sharpen. It's just way too much. So I just get rid of that one. And then that's it. Save that as a JPEG, and I save this as a PSB, so I can always have all my layers, and I can go in and redo everything if something happens. And then that's about it. Like I said, this did take me a good 3 to 4 hours, and a lot of that was in making all my selections. Selecting the museum took a long time, so I had all those railings to get around. Selecting the sky took a while as well. Really makes a difference. Spend the time to do that. So anyway, thanks for watching, and here's this one. I'll show you the staircase. I think that's all I edited for this photo. So anyway, here's the two photos, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.